Because there's no way to have resolve unless you believe that you can overcome your lack of confidence. So you're already building a little confidence then. Okay, I talked to you recently about how you can be successful in certain situations despite a lack of confidence. But the truth is, I know that you want to be more confident. So today the question is, what can you do to increase your confidence if you're starting from zero? If you're someone who just in general doesn't have a lot of confidence, what can you actually do? I'm going to give you a mental framework that you can use to start to build your confidence. So I am Mark Johnson, the founder of Bounce Pep, bringing you ideas for a fit and flourishing future. I'm the youngest son of Bill Johnson. I want to thank you for listening. And if you're a subscriber, thank you very much. If you haven't subscribed, I hope you go ahead and do that. And I hope you like the video as well. But let's jump right in. So the first thing that I want you to understand is where a lack of confidence typically comes from. It's a couple things. In fact, they are a pair. We can say that they're a match made in hell, so to speak. Okay? The first thing is ignorance. The second thing is ineptitude, in no particular order. Okay? But it's really those two things. Ignorance being a lack of knowledge, ineptitude being a lack of ability. Now, here's the thing. This forms the base of our framework. Okay, so the framework for building your confidence begins actually at ignorance and ineptitude on the very bottom. Now, I want you to understand that confidence is a spectrum. It's not as though you start one day with zero confidence and then the next day you have a perfect 10 or 100 or whatever the top of your spectrum would be. Okay, it doesn't work like that. What happens is confidence is built up over time. It's a process. Okay, so once you understand that it's a spectrum and a process, then you know that you're going to have to take time to build your confidence. Okay, so you're starting out at the base with ignorance and ineptitude, right? Now, it could be anything. You could be ignorant about anything. You could be inept in any area. I don't care where it is. Okay. But for you specifically, I want you to think about what that is. Okay. What is that thing that you're really not confident about right now in your life? And what are you trying to overcome? Okay. So once you get that straight, I want you to next start thinking about this. You can't grow by doing what you have always done. This is a key concept. And the point of me saying that is you must grow to like doing what you really don't like doing. I know that that doesn't make sense on the surface, but think about it for a second. The thing that is maybe a little scary, maybe a little uncomfortable, because you don't have knowledge about it and you have no idea what you're doing, that is exactly the thing that you need to embrace. And that's because by embracing it and facing the challenge head on, you can actually start to overcome the ignorance and ineptitude that is keeping you unconfident. Okay, so as I said, the base of your framework is ineptitude and incompetence in no particular order, but that's not where you want to stay. So the next thing that you need is something called resolve. That's the next level up from the ineptitude and the incompetence. Resolve, in other words, resolution. You have to make up your mind that you're going to face that issue. You're going to face that challenge and you're going to do what it takes and invest the time necessary to begin to learn and act and get better so that you gradually overcome the ignorance and the incompetence that is keeping you feeling so unconfident. So the next step is that resolve. Now, after that, you actually have to get down to it. This could be a process of learning about something, but remember, true learning comes from actually implementing. Okay, so it's not simply acquiring knowledge. It's also implementing the knowledge that you've gained, putting it into practice, okay? And what that means is putting in the reps. Now, you know, we take this concept directly from the gym. Putting in the reps. Repping, 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 repping. With every rep, you get a little better. Your muscle memory improves, okay? And over time, you'll start to notice, keep going session after session after session, week after week, month after month, you start to notice that, hey, positive changes are happening, right? So it's the same thing. I want you to, first of all, build your resolve. And then I want you to start working on that thing that you really don't want to start working on, but you know you have to start working on it. You've got to embrace that challenge. So start putting in the reps, okay? Of course, to put in the reps, you have to learn what you're supposed to be doing. For instance, when I was first starting out training, I got a personal trainer, and the personal trainer taught me what I was supposed to be doing and how I was supposed to be doing. And then it was my job to put in the reps. Okay. So it's the same kind of, it's basically the same flow outside of the gym. Okay. Same thing. You got to put in the reps. Okay. Now, the next thing that's going to happen is as you put in the reps and as you keep learning and applying and learning and applying and learning and applying, repping, 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 you're going to develop competence, okay? Now remember, confidence is a scale. So when you start out at the bottom, you're ignorant and inept, you don't have any confidence. When you get resolve, you start to actually have a little bit of confidence then, because there's no way to have resolve unless you believe that you can overcome your lack of confidence. So you're already building a little confidence then. When you start repping, you have already built your confidence even more. And the more you rep and rep and rep, the more your confidence builds. When you actually achieve competence, which is a pretty good ability, which is based on a pretty good knowledge and thorough implementation of something, okay, then your confidence is going to go up some more beyond where it was when you first started repping, okay? So your confidence level is moving up that spectrum. Now, eventually what happens is when you get really, really good at something, you develop something called excellence. And that is beyond, I don't want to say mere competence, because competence is pretty good, okay? But excellence is beyond competence. When you get excellent at something, then your confidence is going to be really high, okay? And this is the framework that I want you to understand and begin to apply. And the value in having this framework is in understanding that you have to start with ignorance and ineptitude. So if that's where you're starting from, and if you feel like a dummy and you feel like you have no, like you just can't do something well, then that's okay, because that's where you have to start. That, like, you're right where you need to be to start building confidence. That is the base of it, okay? So don't let that deter you any longer. The next thing you need to do is build your resolve. You got to resolve to take action and take on the challenge. Stop doing what's comfortable. Stop doing what you already know how to do, because you're not going to grow that way. And you've got to face that challenge that scares you. Face that challenge that you think is going to make you feel like a fool and look like a fool. Don't worry about that. You've got to resolve to face it. Then you've got to start putting in the reps based on the knowledge that you gain. You've got to educate yourself, apply the knowledge, put in the reps. Then you build competence. And if you keep going, you're going to eventually get really, really good. And you're going to be excellent at it. And then your confidence is going to be at the highest level. Okay, so this is how you actually build confidence from nothing. This is your framework. I want you to go back and listen to this message two or three times if you need to. I want you to write the framework down if you need to, but that's it. Okay, so I'm going to leave you with that today. I want you to take this with you, and I'll talk to you next time.